Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, we're going to talk about layer comps and smart objects. Layer comps allow designers to create multiple compositions or comps of a design. Using layer comps, you can create, manage, and view multiple versions of a design in a single Photoshop file. With smart objects, the power of layer comps becomes even more powerful. And by the way, if this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Okay, let's get started. So we're going to work with this file here. It contains two layers. This is just a background and a foreground name logo, but nothing is on that layer. That layer is empty. Also, if you notice, this layer here is a smart object. So if I double click on it, a new tab opens and we have two objects in this smart object. We have a logo and a sale label, and they're both currently disabled. I'm going to go ahead and close this tab, and we still have that logo smart object selected. And in the properties panel, if you don't see that, you can go into window, properties. We have this drop down here that reads don't apply layer comp. But if I click on that drop down, I have different layer comps here. So we have one titled logo bottom left, logo bottom right, bottom left with border, and we have the sale label. So how does this work? Well, I'm going to go back into all disable, and we're going to open up the smart object. And in this smart object, we're going to see how this works. I'm going to double tap on the hand tool just so we can fit everything to screen. And we have the logo and we have the sale. So a layer comp allows you to control the visibility, position, and layer styles of each layer and save them and bring back that instance whenever you need it. So the way that works is by first going into window, layer comps, and we can move a layer to a different location. We can bring down the opacity, and we can double click on it to apply a layer style. So let's apply a drop shadow and move it over to the side and bring the opacity to 100% so that we can see it and press OK. Now I can create a new layer comp, and I'll just call this layer comp tutorial. This is the layer comp that we're creating in the tutorial. Also notice that we're applying the visibility, position, and appearance, which is the layer style, to this layer comp, and press OK. Now if I select logo bottom left, obviously the logo goes back to the bottom left with border. It might be a little hard to tell in the video, but there is a white border around that logo. Logo bottom right, sale, and way at the bottom here, tutorial, we have the one that we just created. So I'm gonna click on all disable because I have a layer comp that disabled everything. And by the way, I want you to notice the icons to the right of a layer comp. They tell you what they control. Notice that for most of these, they control visibility, position, and layer styles. Some of these don't have the layer styles controlled, and that's okay because these particular layer comps don't have any layer styles. So that's okay. So with our new tutorial layer comp, we're going to go back into the original file we are working with. But first, I'm going to set it to disable. Then I'm going to close the tab, save it. And when we come back into the properties panel on this dropdown, we're going to have a layer comp titled tutorial. If I select it, we're going to see that the logo goes into that same position with the same visibility, with the opacity reduced, and with the layer styled apply, the drop shadow. So this is the power of using smart objects with layer comps. So this could be very useful in many areas. For example, if you have a social media account, maybe a Facebook cover photo that has your logo and it moves into different locations depending on the contents of the background, this could be a way of saving you some time because whenever you put in a background, you can quickly come into the dropdown and select the different versions of your logo with the different positions, visibility, and layer styles that you may have. Or, of course, you can create one that doesn't have anything. So what do you think about layer comps and smart objects? Did you know this feature existed? And if you didn't, Do you think you'll be using this technique in the future? Let me know in the comments below. Also, let me know if you have any cool tips and tricks with layer comps and smart objects. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. If you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to click on that like button and share it with a friend. If you're new to the Photoshop training channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.